gotta do one more thing. Gotta do all this shit. Might as well take my time. It is all gonna work out. Okay, so now I gotta really focus and navigate on YouTube. Start interacting with the people on there. Shit, I don't even have it on here. I gotta push everything on Skyrock back to 2022. 2022 is gonna be a good year for me.
Could it also be a perfect fit just for you?
You then lifted up the gamepad, like physically, then a bunch of random no context clips played, and that was it. We're off to a bad start, and we knew it was a bad start because Nintendo's then president, the late great Satoru Iwata, said later that same day, because we put so much emphasis on the controller, there appeared to be some misunderstanding. In an interview with the Evening Standard. Now, before we push onwards, let's take a moment right here and state that if you needed to point to just one thing that cursed the Wii U, it's most likely going to be the gamepad, as it was the main source of its many woes for a cornucopia of reasons. It made the marketing murkier. It wasn't the easiest thing to come to grips with, especially if you had baby heads. And because of its design, routinely would make sure that many ports would never see the light of day. So then let's start with that gamepad. In 2006, if you saw a video of a guy swinging the Wii remote and then it cuts to gameplay showing an enemy getting dusted, it's pretty clear what the appeal was. If your no-no or no-no clicked a video of someone underhanding the Wii remote forward and then saw this, then Nintendo sells 100 million consoles. Those same examples didn't really apply to the gamepad and its functionality. Imagine showing Star Fox Zero or even Nintendo Land to the elderly and expecting something along the same lines.
Yeah, what is it?
Not quite the same effect. Without that easy-to-understand concept, Nintendo is already failing to capture the imagination of that super casual audience. You know, the ones who drove the Wii to outsell the hardcore gamer boxes. In addition, unfortunately, Nintendo also very much failed to appeal to that demographic as well. Fans who waited in lines for major releases and actually paid extra for disc protection on their Call of Duties at GameStop. For a console to sell as staggeringly low as the Wii U, it had to appeal to almost no one. The very next E3, Nintendo very much tried to rectify the mistakes and made sure that the Wii U concept was presented as clearly as it could be, but it still wasn't enough. The gamepad was as big as the console itself and still displayed prominently in the marketing, and it had a screen, so even at a glance, potential customers still had no idea what they were looking at. While you could see glimpses of the Nintendo's quote-unquote asymmetrical nature of, say, Luigi's Ghost Mansion, wasn't nearly as appealing as aiming Link's bow and arrow, or turning the wheel of an Excitra, or better yet, Excite Fly. And then there was the major issue of third-party support. Heading into launch, some publishers were throwing some weight behind the machine, putting out ports of games that the Wii would never have seen. Stuff like Darksiders 2, Ninja Gaiden 3, Razor's Edge, and probably most famously of all, Batman Arkham City, featuring armor from the Armored Edition franchise. Now, while all of those are competent action games, none of them were made for the Wii U specifically in mind, so many critics and fans pointed out their unproven tactile implementations of the gamepad. What was the reason for this? Well, it was due to the fact that they were all tactile implementations of the gamepad.
The river's meeting.
In the case of Armored Edition, it would simply give Batwoman and Catman a slightly different armored skin, like when you tap the screen at the right moment, giving them a slight boost to attack power and speed, and well, that's it. The Wii U was always saddled with these unimpressive ports throughout its lifetime, with very few of them ever being better than what we'd see on competing machines, like Pundle
Reddit's so confusing, dude. I'm gonna have to study that shit.
Very few examples of a third-party succeeding here, including Ubisoft's Zombie U.
Oi. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm done after this. I'm not gonna show y'all everything.